If you're working with clients in any field, having a good system and workflow can be a big part of making sure everything goes smoothly. In this video, I wanted to share with you a tutorial on how to manage your client pipelines and create client portals using only Notion. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with an empty Notion page, and the first thing I'm going to do is go to the top right hand corner three dots and turn on small text full width. This allows us to have more space on the page. The next thing I'm going to do is to title this page. So for this, I'm going to name it Client Portal and Pipeline. Then what I'm going to do is go and add an icon, and I'm going to go ahead and go to the Notion icons, and I'm going to look for something where there's a person here. So I'm going to do this one. And then finally, I can add a cover photo, change cover, and I'll go to Unsplash for a big stock image library, and I'll just choose something like a desk. The next thing I'm going to do is to start creating the databases. In this client portal and pipeline tutorial, I'm only going to create one database where you can contain all of your client notes, pipeline, and also the portal that you can share with your clients. I'm going to type slash and then choose a board view database. So I'm going to title this one clients. Just to make things cleaner, I'm going to click this button and hide the database title. So now we have our board view. I'm also going to rename this one into pipeline. The next thing I'm going to do is to add a sample client. So whenever I build out Notion databases, I like to add a sample as one of the first entries just so that I can make sure that I have everything I need for the properties and the setup. So here I'm going to click here, and let's say that I add someone named John Doe. Now open this one up and then start editing inside. When I change the properties here, all of the future clients that I add to this client portal and pipeline are all going to have the same properties. So the status is definitely important in terms of client management, so I'm going to keep that one. I'm going to delete the assign unless I'm working as a team, so I'm going to delete this one. And a few properties I'm going to add here are going to be, for example, the email address of this client. And then I'll also add a phone number. And you can basically add anything you want here that makes sense for your own client management needs. So this is one reason why I really like Notion, is just the customizability. So here I have email and then phone. Let's say I put a sample email. And the next thing you can do is add an image. This is also optional. So you can go to add cover, change cover, unsplash, and then let's say I add the photo here. So now what I can do is go to the settings. I can choose to adjust the property visibility. So I'm going to show the email and phone number already up front, so it's easy for me to contact these clients. The next thing I'm going to do is, if you'd like, you can show the card preview to be the page cover, and then you can turn on fit image. If you don't need the image, then you can go ahead and go to layout and then make card preview none. So the next thing I'm going to do is to open John Doe up, and I'm going to adjust the status property. So right now it's in the default mode, which is not started, in progress, and done. In the case of client pipelines, I would like to have more statuses so I can see exactly how the client is moving through the pipeline. So I'm going to go ahead and click the status. I'm going to edit the property, and now I can add custom statuses. So instead of not started, I'm just going to add perspective. And then I'll actually set this one as the default, and then I will delete this one. The next thing is the in progress statuses. I'm going to add discovery call. And I'll also add one that's called negotiation. So in the case where we're negotiating the pricing, it could go here, and I'll delete the in progress option. And as you can see, you can also change the color here if you'd like. So I'm going to delete this one. And for your needs, it might look very different from what I might need with working with Notion clients. So this again is a very customizable area in terms of how you want to adjust the client pipeline. For the complete, what I'm going to add is lost. So in the case that the client decides not to go forward, and I'll also change that to red. And then I'll also add active. And then finally there's done. So I'll just put brown for that one. So this is what my client pipeline is going to look like. And when I click out of John Doe, now my board view is also reflecting those changes. So when John Doe moves to discovery call, I can drag him there. Negotiation, lost, active, or done. So if I put him back to perspective, the next thing I'm going to do is just adjust the visuals here a bit. So I don't really need to see the lost column and also the done column. So I'm going to go ahead and adjust those by going to the settings. And then I'm going to go to the group. And here you can adjust the settings for each of your groups. So let's say that I want to hide lost, but I still want to pin it to the side. I want to also hide the done, but still pin it to the side. So now both are pinned and then both are also hidden. So now I can see that perspective, discovery, call, negotiation, active really clearly here, and everything else can be in the pinned groups. So now that we have the pipeline, the next thing I'm going to do is to add a view, which is going to be in gallery view. And I'm going to name this view active clients. So this way you can also see only your active clients that you're currently working with. The next step is going to be to go to settings, and I'm going to go to layout. You can choose to show the card preview again, whether that's page cover, and I'll turn on fit image. Then the next thing I'm going to do is to go and adjust their property visibility. And then I want to see this time the email and phone just like before. And then finally, I'm going to add the filter, which is that the status is active. And you're also welcome to create more views here if you want to see the lost clients in a new tab and so on. There's so much flexibility here too that you can add so that it works with your own workflow. So now that we have the pipeline and the active clients tab, I'm going to show you how to create a client portal. For client portals, what I recommend doing is to add a database template. That means that every time you create a new client, it's going to have the same template and it's going to have that same portal that you can customize specifically for each client. So I'm going to go ahead and click this one plus new template, and I'm going to type new client. So this also depends on your own workflow, but you can add a section here for taking notes, especially if you do discovery calls. So I'm going to go ahead and type slash heading 3. And this one is going to be where you can have your notes. What I like here with the new feature is that you can actually add the Notion AI meeting notes. So if you have that in your Notion plan, be sure to use that. You can just start transcribing when you start your discovery call with a client, and everything ends up in Notion, and it'll even give you action lists and all of these things. So I'm going to add my Notion AI meeting notes here inside of this template. I can also add a spot for my own notes if I need to outside of that discovery call. Then I'm going to add a heading 3 for documents. So in case that you want to add some internal documents, you can add an embed here like this, where you can just embed anything you want. You can duplicate this as well, however many documents you want to add here. And then finally, we have the client portal. So I'm going to go ahead and type up here so that it's clear, heading 3, client portal slash divider. And what we're going to do here is to add another page inside of this page. So I'm going to do slash page, and this one is going to be called client. And then you can add the client name here. And this page is going to be a forward facing page that you're going to be able to share with your client so that they know all of the deliverables, the project descriptions, invoices, all kinds of important information that you can add here. So I would recommend making sure that the client portal template is customized in a way that shows your brand image and matches your brand identity. So you could go ahead and add a cover photo for that and then change cover. And this time you could even upload your own brand assets. I'm going to go to Unsplash and just look for something minimal to add here. But feel free to play around with this to make sure that it kind of matches your aesthetic. And then I'm going to go ahead and add an icon. Here again, you can even upload your company's logo, for example. I'm just going to go ahead and add something like this. And now we can get started with customizing the client portal. So inside of this page, the first thing I would recommend adding is a callout box. And this can help with having a welcome message. You can type any kind of message to welcome your client to this client portal and make sure that they understand what this is. So now I have my welcome message. Again, you can really customize this as well for your own needs. You can even change the color of the callout box by going to color like this. The next thing you can do is to type slash, and then I'm going to add toggle heading 2. And here you can add project description. And if you'd like, you can type your sample project description inside. And then I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this one. So you can highlight this and then either click duplicate, or I'm just going to go ahead and type command D a bunch of times so that I have a bunch of these toggles. So the next thing you might want to do is to have the calendar so that you can see the timeline. Inside the calendar, I'm going to type slash calendar, and I'll add a calendar view database, empty database, and this one I'll type calendar, and then hide database title. Just to test it, I would add one sample in here. Let's say that send project proposal. And I will also add a checkbox so you can see if it's done. And then you can either have the tag here or you can delete this one. I'm going to go ahead and change the property visibility so that it shows the done. And now we have send project proposal here. If you want a wider view for this, you can also turn it into full width, but I would recommend keeping it in this style so it's a little bit easier to read the main text, and you can always click things open. For the next toggle, you could add something like invoices and then have slash embed so that you can easily see which invoices have been paid. So you could do invoice 1 and then have that embed in there. Then another thing you could have would be documents. So if there's any important documents, again, you can do slash embed and then add in any PDFs, Google Docs, anything you want in the documents. And then finally, you could add something like notes so that you could keep track of any notes. Or if you want the client to also access this and edit this client portal, you could also have a space for them to take notes as well. And then I'm going to type slash table and have a simple table view database here plus empty database for notes. And then I'll hide the database title. I'm going to add the date here so that you can keep track of the date. And then you could have your notes. So now we have our client portal set up. So this is basically just a template that you can reuse each time you add a new client. I would recommend deleting anything in the databases. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that one and make sure I don't have any notes in here, or it's going to duplicate into every client. So now we have the client portal ready. I'm going to go ahead and go back to new client, and then I'm going to go back to my client's database, and it should be saved here. If you want to set this as a default, you can set it as default. So every time you add a new client, it's automatically going to just add that template in for you. So I'll go ahead and set it as default for all views and clients. Just to check, I'll add a new client here. And if I open this new client up, we have the client portal inside. I have my AI meeting notes inside and the documents inside. If I click open that client portal, then I also see everything in here, including the calendar that I just added. So this really streamlines the process, makes it easier each time you have a new client to just go through the same processes. If you want to edit that template, you can go ahead and go here and then edit that template. Just be careful that the new template isn't going to be reflected in any of the old pages you've already created. So you will have to either reset the entire thing and delete everything or create a new client. So now that we have the client portal and pipeline ready, let's go ahead and go over what this would look like in use. So I'm going to go ahead and use that new client that we created. I'm going to name this one Jane Smith, and I would have her email and phone number, and then I would fill that in as soon as she is a prospect. And then the next step is going to be that maybe I meet her for a discovery call so I can start transcribing or writing notes as I meet with her. Then if there's any documents that I need to keep track of, I can add them here internally. And then when I'm ready, I can move Jane to discovery call, and then I can move Jane Smith into negotiation when we're starting to talk about the quotes and whether or not she wants to move forward with the project. And then I can actually share that client portal with Jane. So what that's going to look like is I'm going to open it up. I would put her name here. Then I would start filling everything in. So I can add my project description. I can add a timeline calendar here. I could add any invoices as that comes up, any payment information, documents, and then any notes. And to invite Jane Smith into this client portal, there are a few options. You can go to share here. And then what you can do is invite her via email. When you invite her via email, there's going to be several access opportunities here. So you can either have her as just can view. Sometimes this can be the simplest option just because some clients aren't used to using Notion. So all they can do is just view it, that they can comment, but they can't edit it. And then this also can edit and then full access. So if you really want something where you can also work together with your client, then you might want to do a full access as well, especially if the client's comfortable using Notion. You can also choose to publish this to the web, but there is a security concern here in that there's no way to actually lock it with a password if you're only using Notion. There are some ways to do this with third-party tools, but for now you can only publish it to the web, and then what happens is that you can turn the search engine indexing off and it'll only be accessible with this unique link. And if you share this page to your client, they'll only get to see this page. So anything you write in here won't be viewable by the client. So you can really keep track of internal notes inside. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in custom design services or pre-made solutions, the link to my client portal templates are in the description below. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.